Now question number 2, its second part is, draw this figure in your notebook. It looks like that. Now, do you know what is the measure of this one? It is a symbol of which one angle? Yes, it is a symbol of right angle. So its measure is 90 degree. Now, again one angle is at the exterior of the triangle, but we cannot apply exterior angle property. Why? Because according to exterior angle property, it will equal to sum of interior opposite angle. But here we don't know value of pi as well as I, so we cannot apply. So what should we do? Just rotate this figure, rotate your notebook. Can you see that what type of triangle it is? These two lines, what they represent? Yes, it represents that this one triangle is an isosceles triangle. And their base angle, the angle opposite to this one side is x, the angle opposite to this one side is, let me take as angle 1. Okay, so their value also equal, that means angle 1 is also x, the measure of angle 1 is also xy, because it is base angle of the isosceles triangle. So write here that angle 1 is equal to x, base angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Now you get value of angle 1, that is x, this one x, and 90 degree. Can you find value of x from here? Yes, by angle sum property you can find value of x, which is equal to angle 1 plus angle x plus 90 degree is equal to 180 degree. As you know, value of angle 1 is x, so x plus 90 degree is equal to 180 degree. X plus x, it will come 2x plus 90 degree is equal to 180 degree. 2x is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree. Then x is equal to 180 minus 90, 90 divided by 2, it will come 45 degree. So thus you can say value of x is 45 degree, and x will equal to angle 1. So you can write here that angle 1 measure is also 45 degree. Now to find value of y, you can apply exterior angle property here, that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angle. Why? Because we know that now the value of x is 45 degree, so you can put here 45 degree plus 90 degree, y is equal to, it will come 135 degree. Or second method is, you can apply linear pair between these two angles, that means angle 1 and y. So I done it like that. By linear pair, angle 1 plus y is equal to 180 degree. Angle 1 value I know, 45 degree, put it here. 45 degree plus y is equal to 180 degree. Now y is equal to 180 degree minus 45 degree, it will come y is equal to 135 degree. In both cases you will get the same answer. That means you can do by any method, but your property must be correct. Okay, so thus you can say that x is equal to 45 degree and y is equal to 135 degree. Our next topic is condition to be a triangle. That means, how can we verify that a triangle can be drawn with the given measurement sides or not? So it is, condition to be a triangle means the sum of the length of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. It must be greater than, that is, the sum of the length of any two sides of the triangle is greater than the third side. Like this, that sum of the length of any two side is greater than third side. It must be greater than third side. Example, this one is a triangle, its measurements are given, and the question asks, is it possible to have a triangle with side 3 cm, 6 cm and 7 cm? So how can we check that a triangle is possible with these sides or not? So the condition is, that condition to be a triangle, na? That means this condition must be satisfied to draw a triangle or to get a triangle. So let us check. As the condition is, sum of length of any two sides must be greater than third side. So let take any two sides. Suppose I am taking 6 cm and 7 cm first. Sum of any two sides, that is 6 cm plus 7 cm, its sum must be greater than third one side, that is 3 cm. When I add it, I will get 13 cm, which is greater than 3 cm. Is it 13 greater 3? Yes. So you said that first condition is satisfied. Now secondly, you can take the other two sides like 7 and 3. Just take sum of 7 centimeter and 3 centimeter. It must be greater than the third one side. Now third one side will come as 6 centimeter. Because these are the sum of two sides. No? The third one side is this. Its sum is 10 centimeter, which is greater than 6 centimeter. So yes, second condition is also satisfied. Now third condition must be that now take sum of these two sides. The sum must be greater than the third one side. 6 centimeter plus 3 centimeter greater than third one side is 7 centimeter. When I add, it will come 9 centimeter greater 7 centimeter. It means yes, 9 centimeter is greater than 7 centimeter. That means all these three conditions are satisfied. Thus you can say, therefore the triangle is possible with these three sides. Is it clear?